My name is Theresa. I am 56 years old. I live in Phoenix, Arizona, and I'm addicted to my hairless rats. This is my Coco. I have Nellie here. This is my sweet comes Blindy, and she is my little pride and joy. I'm known as the Rat Lady.
Teresa's addiction began 10 years ago when a boyfriend introduced her to hairless rats. Now her studio apartment overflows with 52 of them.
The first time I've seen one, I was kind of repulsed by these critters with no hair. Now we're a unit in a family together.
I love you.
I felt I've made many bad decisions, poor choices, and did not do everything I should have done. My family hasn't had any contact at all with me. So my rats give me this unconditional love I can't get anywhere else.
My mom's addiction it's a weird addiction and obsession that she has. Like, who really is addicted to rats? It's not normal.
Teresa treats her rats like human companions.
My rats just love to eat anything. You can make spaghetti for them, pizza, chocolate, and cupcakes. Come on, you stinky butts. Look at these happy munching faces.
Teresa also sleeps with her rats.
We all get comfortable. The group will lay over there in their little blanket. It might be two or three that's laying near me.
Teresa's unemployed and struggles to pay her rent. She often buys rat food before she pays her bills.
I just got this on the door. It's an eviction notice. Me and my rats could be out in the streets.
She feeds her rats before she'll feed herself. It's crazy.
Your favorite, uh-oh.
If you want to be part of other people's lives, then you have to learn to be more responsible. You know you can't afford to keep these rats. Why would you ask your daughter to buy your rat food?
I'm ashamed of that, and I'm sorry I did at the time.
So now you need to make a change. Now is the time. Not next month, not a year from now, now.
I don't know if I can part with them. They become so dear to me.
The thought of Teresa sleeping with these rats in her bed because of disease, they could bite her, scratch her, just worries me.
I am embarrassed about this addiction because people were kind of mostly repulsed by me.
This has just gone out of hand. Look at this.
They're not that bad.
They're disgusting, and I just can't stand to be in here. If my mom decides to stay on the path that she's at, to be honest with you, I don't know if I want her in my life. I could shut her out, like everyone in my life has told me to do, basically. But I still feel like I want to be the one that helps her. People have nightmares over rats. Rats are like this disgusting creature.
Not mine. Mine are hairless. Mine have all been born in my apartment. None of them have been exposed to disease or rats that are wild.
But Mom, you have like 20 rats in one cage. They have no room to like breathe or even live. They smell. This is an addiction, Mom. This is serious.
I'm willing to sell, give up some of them. Not all of them. Who would want a three-legged, half a tail rat? Who would want one that's blind in one eye? I don't think it's very fair of her to expect me to get rid of every single one. I will feel the emptiness like you wouldn't believe.
You don't think that people are going to cut you off, that you don't think your own daughter would stop talking to you. And I would.
Jennifer, I love you more than anything. You are the most important thing in my life. The rats come secondary to you.
Sometimes I don't know if what she's saying is actually the truth or it's just telling me what I want to hear.
I have to admit, it's gotten out of hand, especially when I don't have the food or the money and at the time to clean the cages. My daughter Jennifer gave me a very strong ultimatum that it was her or the rats. I don't know, I'm so torn what to do.
So the rats are keeping you from having that relationship?
I think so, only because I'm so grossed out by them. So I don't even want to come over to her apartment.
What are you feeling right now, Teresa? Because in your face, you are clearly showing a lot of emotion and
I'm feeling ashamed that I let these animals come between our relationship. I love my daughter.
You have these rats, and that's your number one.
No, you were number one.
She's had so many options to change, and I don't know if she will. That's what I'm afraid of.
It makes me ashamed that I would ever choose an animal over my beautiful daughter. And she should, I never expected that she would have this view, that it would be this bad or like
okay,
this.
Jen, do you believe your mom right now?
It's hard to believe those words just because it's been going on and she's only been accumulating them, not getting rid of them really. So it's hard, you know, having why all of a sudden is she saying these words to me and why, I guess, I just want to hope it's true and that she actually understands like the sincerity of it, that it's really coming, you know, like kind of a burden between us and it, I just...
So have you heard your mom say this before to you?
She said that, you know, she has too many and she, you know, puts a lot of effort into them. But I think she really denies how much effort she actually gives to them and how much time and how much money it takes to keep these, you know, rats in her apartment. And she just doesn't put herself first.
Do you think that's true, Teresa?
I think it's true that I have spent way too much time and it's become too much of a burden with my changing, cleaning cages, changing their litter.
If she's willing to give me a chance, I have to make the effort too.
Okay, what does that mean for the rats?
I'm going to sell them or give them away to places that can find them right homes.
Okay.
And keep just a few. And put those in cages,
how many
no more sleeping with animals.
How many is a few?
About 8.
Okay, how does that sound to you, Jen?
If that's really all she can deal with to part at this point, that'd make me happy.
For Teresa and Jen to both be emotionally invested at this point is a huge step.
I realize that I'm giving a very important chance to get my act together. I'm going to make it happen.